Have a discussion. It's it's the holidays and people are out and having fun and enjoying themselves, but also around this time you tend to notice that accidents on the road happen quite frequently, more so than the rest of the year. So today we're going to talk about why it is important for you to drink responsibly, to be responsible on the roads, and talk a little bit about road safety and how it is that you can get from point A to point B alive without harming yourself or other people. I have two guests who are here with me, so I'll ask you to introduce yourself.
My name is Fred Majiwa and I work for St. John Ambulance.
Okay, karibu Fred.
My name is Agnes Mwaniki. I work with St. John Ambulance.
Okay. Now you have quite an interesting story, even as just getting on stage or seeing that you came with crutches. So maybe we can begin with your story and how it is that you ended up where you are.
Okay, on my side, it was like 2 years ago. I got an accident. It was 2015, June. I got an accident. Nilikuwa tu natoka job. So nilikuwa tu kwa pavement nikienda home. Then there is a car coming in a speed, but walikuwa megonga mtu mwingine, so alikuwa anatoroka. So then akakuta akanitoa kwa pavement, akanigonga akienda kutoroka, dio akaingia kwa mtaro. So I thank God sikukufa, though nimepitia mambo mingi sana, because I nimeenda 2 theaters. I have a femur on my right leg. Then after 2 years, imekuja ikapata shida ingine. So maybe God willing, date 19 this month, naenda another theater, because I have a problem. So what I can say, drivers, when you wanna drive magari, kwanza wakati wa Christmas, wanafaa wakue wagalifu sana, cause wamebeba abilia. Kue very careful kwa kila mtu, unabeba passengers, unabeba mzazi wako, sisters, brothers. So we have to be very keen wakati tuko kwa barabara.
The person who hit you, was it a drunk driver?
Yes.
Okay.
He was drunk because after alcohol brew, alikuwa, I think 0.62.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a lot of alcohol.
Yeah. He was drunk at kabisa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fred, you've seen various situations on the ground when, you know, these accidents happen, specifically on weekends. And I have some statistics from NTSA that I'll share as well. But what hits you when you get to that scene and you're seeing either loss of life or people badly injured, when all of this could have been avoided by people being responsible?
Yeah, and when it comes to the period of December, usually it's a very happy time and most people are enjoying themselves. But you find that in that happiness, some people turn it to be sadness. And it only takes a simple carelessness and you ruin somebody's family, you ruin people's livelihood. So most of those accidents occur because people are drinking under influence of alcohol. You find that somebody is taking one for the road. Then alcohol tells that person something, that there is no roundabout. It's just a highway. And the next minute you find yourself hanging on top of a roundabout. And at that moment, sometimes you can be lucky that we can come and rescue you and we take you to hospital. But sometimes you end up in the morgue and you see, instead of your family waiting for a happy moment, they're just meeting sadness.
Yeah.
So I think this period, I think we can make a difference. Last year we lost averagely about 300 lives in December alone. And this
in
year,
December alone.
Yes. And this year, I'm sure we can make a difference only if we decide that when we drink, we will have a designated driver or you use a cab.
Yeah.
Or rather, Uber.
Because
is,
the options are there. Yeah. I mean, I don't even understand. It's not like we don't have options. There's so many, cab apps these days that you can have on your phone. If you know that that's your intention is to go out and drink, Why is it that people still don't get that?
It's funny to understand people sometimes. But I understand that when you look at Africa, Kenya is ranking third amongst the top drinking countries. That's third after Nigeria and maybe Uganda. And that's why you can see there are a lot of fatalities in those countries mentioned. So drinking is causing a lot of fatalities on our roads. And as I've said before, there are a lot of options that are there. You see, after taking alcohol, it's very easy for alcohol to cheat you.
Yeah.
That now you are imara kama simba. But the next minute you will
be
imara.
Or these people who say gari inajua home. It's very unfortunate. It's quite a serious issue. According to NTSA, Kenya's record is one of the highest traffic death rates in the world, with 29 deaths per 100,000 people on Kenyan roads. And we see other countries that are much safer, and they go into that as well. Also from NTSA, one in every five people who die from road injuries in Kenya is aged below 20 years. And again, that's a lot of these young people that are here today. And it's something that we really need to take seriously. Maybe you can talk to us about, you know, you were just a pedestrian on the road that day. You weren't expecting your life to change the way it did. But it only takes that one person who's made an improper decision for your life to change forever. How has your life changed since that accident?
Okay, from that time, I was walking very comfortable. But after accidents, I can't do... I mean, right now, I do light duties. Kuna vitu mingi sana siwezi jifanyia. Maybe you are the breadwinner. Everybody look at you. They want everything, but challenges ni mingi sana. Cause tangu hiyo time, enye nimepitia ni mambo magumu sana. Yes.
What would you want to tell people, you know, particularly in this holiday season, people who are going out and they're drinking and they're not really thinking about how their actions affect others? What would you say to that person, like the person who caused that accident? What would you want to say to them if you had an opportunity?
Okay, chenye naezambia watu kwanza young generation, hawaonangi kitu kubwa. Maybe wakati munaenda outing, kama saa hii, mukitoka hapa musiende kwa mambo baya, cause you never know. Kwa magari, kuna vile... Watu wengine wanainakaka wamebeba hizo vitu zao. But si vizuri. Take your time. Wakati utakuwa at least umejisimamia, hakuna mtu atakuuliza. But right now you are too young, so you have to maintain yourself.
Yeah. Also, according to NTSA, one in five who die from road accidents in Kenya is a child or a teenager. And I found that statistic particularly disturbing. One in 40 deaths in Kenya caused by road accidents. What is it going to take, do you think, for us to understand this message, for the message to get through to us?
Yeah, in most occasions you find that when we are talking about accidents, we always put the blame on the drivers. But also we have drink walking. There are people who are drinking, then they walk on the road, then it's very easy for them to be run over by vehicles, that especially those which are over speeding. But when it comes to people, you see, there are two things that you can't mix. There is driving, there is drinking. You have to choose one. If you drink, you don't drive. If you drive, you don't drink. When you mix the two, you'll make us reach 3,000 deaths by the end of the year, which is very sad.
Yeah. Very sad, and we see the peak times or peak days when these accidents happen, particularly on weekends, you know, early hours of the morning around 4 or 5 a.m. is when you're seeing people who've rolled onto a roundabout or, you know, where these accidents are happening. So we clearly know that this person has been out, they've been drinking, and yet they feel like somehow they're immune from that.
Yeah, most people think that accident happened to other people. it's not them that are involved in accidents. But accident occurs anytime, and it only takes a simple carelessness and accident occurs. And the next minute you'll find a lot of blood all over. The next minute you'll find somebody calling St. John Ambulance. There is a very bad accident that has occurred here. And we rush there. And you find that when we find those who have survived, luckily we rush them to hospital. But a substantial number are not lucky and they end up in the morgue. Yeah, another thing, you find that most fatalities are about young people. It's young people who are very willing to take risks. Mm. It's young people who are willing to walk on the road when they are under influence of alcohol. It's young people who are willing to drive the car even if they are under influence of alcohol. And we can make a difference. We can change. We can make this year a year of change and say, all of us, we will not drink and drive. And by the end of the year, we will not end up with the crazy number of deaths that we always witness.
Yeah, but that change starts with all of us making that resolve.
Yes, sure.
I'm going to take final comments from both of you. Just final comments to people watching right now as they get ready to, you know, start enjoying the holiday season. We've been talking dangers of drinking and driving and the importance of road safety. So what would you be your final comments on that?
Okay, on my side, I can say don't drink and drive because pombe si mzuri. Pombe si mzuri, okay, tunaonanga ni mzuri but si mzuri. So what I can say, I wish you all Merry Christmas and happy prosperous happy new year. Na musikunywe pombe.
Fred, I'll take final comments from you as well.
Yeah, I'm sure this year we are going to have a very happy new year and a Merry Christmas. And the onus is on all of us. We can always change. I say this. The only thing that you can control when you are under influence of alcohol is your mouth, to drink and to talk a lot. But the other faculties will be, you will not control them. You will not control the legs, you will not control the mind, and you will not control your hands. And the next minute, if you don't control your leg, the pedestrian is going to be your brake instead of the pedal being your brake. And the next minute, if you don't control your hands, the ditch is going to control the car for you. This year, we are going to make it a very, very prosperous New Year and a Merry Christmas.
Well, thank you both for that encouraging message. Again, like I said, there are options. There is absolutely no reason for you to get behind a vehicle if you have been drinking. All right, so we're going to take a short break right now, and we'll be back here on 10 over 10 with more. Don't go away.